got enough money already, Gunna. I'm sorry. Free one of them, though. No cap. Alright, y'all. So, a few quick updates that y'all don't know about. I did move. I finally moved. We finally moved. My mom finally moved. It's a big accomplishment for her. I haven't really came on here and talked about it, but my mom officially owns her own house. This is big for us, you know, growing up. My mom was renting a lot. We rented all the places that we stayed. And, you know, it's a big accomplishment. I haven't really been able to enjoy myself living here because if y'all don't know, I get seasonal cluster headaches. And basically what that is the same time every single day for a duration of the year, I get headaches and they're excruciating. It's like someone's stabbing me in my eye. All this side is just numb. Sometimes like I can't open that eye. Like it gets really, really bad. So, you know, I've been trying to not bring any negativity to the vlogs and talk about what's going on in my personal life. But, you know, I thought this would be something that I could tell y'all about. And we did officially move. I am back living in Stratford. It's a great feeling to be back home. This is where I was born at. Well, this is where I was raised at. We had that debate the other day, me and Toya, about wherever you born is not where you raised. But I look at it as this is home. Stratford is home, and I'm happy that my mom is somewhere that she's comfortable. So, you know, with all those things being said, we are officially in our own place, in our own, you know what I'm saying, domain. And it's big, man. This is huge. It's definitely huge. So yeah. That little walk down the down the porch area and everything like that, that was, you know, a new scenery for y'all. So yeah, I'm grateful. I'm definitely grateful and I'm humbled. It's motivating, and I tell y'all all the time, use things as motivation. My mom getting her own, it's motivation for me. You know what I'm saying? It's motivation to me because I didn't have people in my life, people in my family that I seen go and get their own property and, you know, go through the process and seeing how the process is. And I was there, like, you know, every step of the way, every update, every hiccup that we went through, going to see the houses. You know, I wasn't there for every single thing, but I was there for a lot of it. And, you know, it was a journey, and it's still a journey. You know, she's doing a lot of renovations and things like that. You know, one thing I always say is parents know how to, you know, make something work. Because it's not easy having your own and wanting it to be the way that you want it to be. The thing that I've learned and the thing I am still learning is adulting is expensive, bro. Being an adult is very, very, very expensive, and it's not easy. So the things that I've seen her pull together is amazing. It's really amazing to see her do the things that she's done. And yeah, it feels good to finally be able to come home and park in front of my house instead of parking all the way down the street and having to walk all the way up. It feels good to know that my car is safe outside, you know? It's good to know that, you know, when I do get back into my car washes on a daily, that I'm able to, you know my car is good outside, not get a car wash and so many cars flying by the street that it makes it damn near impossible for you to tell that I got a car wash on the left side of my car. You know, things like that, people sleep on, people don't really think about until you're not in a place where those things are convenient for you. And I'm just happy to be back home, bro. I'm happy to be back where, you know, my stomping grounds are. At this age, you know, I haven't lived in Stratford since, I think, 2019. I think 2019 it was when we moved out. 2019 or 2020. One of those two. We moved out of Stratford, moved to Bridgeport, and we was living there until earlier this year. And it just feels great to be in somewhere new. I still didn't put my room together. I still didn't do all the things I want to do for my room. Moving has made me, like I said, see that how expensive things are. You know, getting furniture is really expensive. It's not cheap. It's not as simple as it may seem. You know, my mom pulled things out of her, you know what I'm saying, to make things work for me as a kid. Like, you know, the furniture I had since we lived in Stratford, and I brought it over there, and it was, you know, deteriorating because of all the years that I had it. But you never know how expensive furniture is until you got to buy it yourself. You never know how expensive, you know, soap, water, all them things that you take for granted as a kid, how expensive that shit is. Like, seriously, you start becoming numb to things that you don't pay for because you don't know how much it is to pay for it. One of the big wake-up calls for me recently was having to get these tires done. Like, I got my tires done last year, but, you know, there's things that I didn't care about getting done on the other car because, you know, it being what it was. Sometimes you don't appreciate what you got as much when you don't actually, like, put your blood, sweat, and tears into that. I put my blood, sweat, and tears into this car. I went completely broke when I first got this car. I was broke as shit. I had nothing left to my name, not a single dime. The moment I got this car, it's a little update for you. I hate when people do that. Just try to force their way through. The moment I got this car, that first day, I enjoyed it. The second day, I was doing Instacart literally all day in this car. I could not afford this car. And that's what things that I'm doing right now. Like, you know, I'm taking sacrifices. I'm taking risks with the things that I've been buying, the things I've been investing into. I've been investing into nothing but my YouTube channel lately. I haven't been, like, you know, going out and going to do so much fun stuff. Everything revolves around my YouTube channel now. I'm hungry. If as a YouTuber, it's hard to get that get that drive and that spark again. On my main channel, I'm doing things I never thought I would do. My thumbnails are coming out the ways that I never thought they would. I feel like I'm in a certain category on YouTube now that I never thought I could be in. I'm grateful for where I am in life right now. Regardless of the headaches, regardless of, you know, struggling to try to make sure I get things done, I'm taking sacrifices right now, man. And it's a lot of sacrifices behind the scenes that y'all don't see. But I'm investing into my YouTube videos now. I'm spending actual money to film main channel YouTube videos that I don't get. I don't get no money from YouTube. I don't. I get $0 from YouTube. So I'm investing my hard-earned money into something that I'm not getting rewarded for. And that's how hard I'm going for it. And I'm trying to prove it to myself, prove it to y'all, and prove it to, you know, I always look at it as God is giving you things and giving you signs to see if you're built. How bad do you really want it? That's how I look at it. I feel like things just don't fall in your lap for certain reasons. I feel like everything's a sign. And sometimes I get these signs from God that I personally feel like, I don't know how religious you guys are, but when I personally get these signs from God of like, I need to be doing this or I need to be doing that, these signs, I don't ever overlook them. I always take it for what it is, and I try to, like, okay, he's showing me this, so I need to be doing this. And I mean, there's so many signs to get back on YouTube and finally do what I want to do. The engagement, the support is just amazing, and I just want to say thank you so much for all the support y'all give me. The vlog channel is not slept on. I've just been trying to figure out things and go with the flow, you know, navigating through my headaches, navigating through work, and just trying to find that balance in my life of where I can do everything in 24 hours. And lately, I haven't been having 24 hours. My days get cut short because of these headaches. With these cluster headaches, they can last from 10 o'clock in the morning till 5 o'clock in the afternoon. 5 o'clock in the evening, some would say. And that's a long time to lose out on a day. Because what that does is it doesn't allow me to be as productive as I want to be, and that's never good for me. So I'm just trying to deal with it and keep on working and keep on pushing through. And I feel like it's going to be a reward out of this. There's going to be a reward coming soon, and I just hope that y'all stick around to see it. I appreciate all y'all support, and yeah, let's continue the rest of the vlog. All right, y'all, so I just picked her up, and yo, you so extra. And we about to get something to eat, but it's freaking 4:52, and y'all see what it is. I mean, on the camera it looks a lot better, but it's getting dark already. And it's like, yo, this is why, like, I like this time of the year, because one of my favorite movies ever is In Season.
I know.
And what's my favorite movie?
Pole Express.
Yeah, that is my favorite movie, like, of all time.
Christmas movie.
But it's just like, bro, you can't even This is like the worst time of the year for YouTubers. Like, I'm not even joking. Because if you want to do something, you got to do that shit so early. So early, bruh. Or you feel like the day is already over. Because once the sun go down, I don't know about you, but I feel like the day is over.
Yeah.
It's like you already start feeling tired. You already want to go in the house. And it's like the day is not even close to over yet. But daylight savings, that's what they do.
Next year is the last year. I mean, this year is the last year.
Hopefully.
They say.
Hopefully. I mean, I do kind of like it when it gets like extremely, extremely cold. Because it's like, 9 out of 10, you really ain't going nowhere like that. Like, crazy, crazy. Sometimes we'll go places, but, I mean, Connecticut already, you already ain't doing nothing in Connecticut, so. But, we about to go and get some Popeyes. But I'm about to go where I used to live. Because I had told them about how we moved. Yeah. So, we about to go where I used to live, because there's a thing that you can do at the gas station where I used to live. I'm about to put y'all in the game. I don't know if it'll work out wherever y'all live at, but I only noticed it work at this Sunoco that I used to go to. And it's a gas trip. And I remember back in the day, I went to the gas station, right? And it was this lady, and somebody kept on asking, like, hey, can you put like $5 in my tank? And she was like, I can't do it because I'm doing a gas trip myself. And I always wondered what she was saying. I was just there. But I always wonder what the hell she was talking about. She was like, gas trick. And now I know.
Yeah,
I don't know. Nah, I don't know. I don't remember exactly what gas station it was. I just remember vividly, like, her saying, like, oh, no, I'm doing a gas trick. And, yeah, there's a gas trick. If you want to get gas, this is what you can do to get some gas. I'm driving all the way to where we used to live, just to do this. Because I'm
like
taking
30 minutes.
It's not no 30 minutes, but it's. I was telling them too how like I've been taking sacrifices, like getting stuff that I really can't afford at the moment to better myself and put more money into my YouTube videos and shit. So this will come with it. Broke boy don't got no gas in his car, right? I gotta go get some gas, man. But yeah, today is our preparation for tomorrow's video. That she ain't gonna be able to survive.
Oh, yeah.
Is there anything that you noticed that you do in the recent days that is gonna be a hard thing for you to deal with tomorrow?
I feel like tomorrow, especially, I have packages coming, so I'm gonna work them all
Yeah. You don't wanna stay on, know where they at. Yeah. Only thing I feel like I'm not even bad at is just when I'm eating. I like to watch something. So that's like one of the, I guess you could say, bad habits that I have, where it's gonna be hard for me tomorrow to not be able to pull out my phone and watch a YouTube video while we eating. Sometimes I pull it out, but I feel like it's gonna be easier though because we're gonna be with each other. And I feel like most people, when they do stuff like that, they'll be by themselves, and that's when it's hard because you're disconnected from the whole world. Like, so I feel like we kind of taking the easy route. But yeah, tomorrow we're doing a 24 hours without the phone. And this is the preparation for it. We got a couple things planned. But one of the things I told her is that we got to figure out is that one of the places I want to go to, well, I can tell you, which is IKEA. I don't know how to get there.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
What the heck? Why are you acting? She acting like I'm buying the whole store. We used to go in there and explore.
I know, but it's just so big and nice.
Yeah, I know. So that's one of the places we're going tomorrow. And I don't know exactly how to get there. I know you just got to keep going down, but it's a certain way you got to get there. Like, once you get off the highway.
We're going right down the
right.
You're
going to write down directions. Like, we back in the
okay,
the
so 80s. I'm going to do it like we're leaving my house and going there.
Yeah. So we got to write down the directions for that. Everything else that we doing tomorrow is pretty much regular stuff that we would go to, like go to the beach and what else I said. We going in the movies at the end of the night
to see Black Panther.
To see Black Panther. We could talk about everything because this video not going up until the day that video goes up. So then just go up after.
I want to see Black Panther. I can't wait. I'm so excited to see that.
Yeah, no, I am excited to see that.
we had to buy our tickets when everybody else had to buy their tickets because it's gonna be sold out. Like it's packed. Let me go see if somebody sit by us. We get seats so nobody can't sit by us.
Not for sure. We'll get it like intentionally. Like we'll be on the edge. And we'll try to buy the two seats that's like next to the edge, but not the edge seat, just so that somebody like. Sometimes somebody will sit next to us, which pisses us off sometimes because you look on a chart and there'll be mad seats available, but they chose to sit next to us. But we try to do that shit intentionally, so at least one side of the shit, someone's not sitting next to us. Because that's the only thing I hate about the movies is when somebody's sitting directly next to us and they're mad, loud, and belligerent.
Ooh, like, and chewing?
Yeah, OMG. Chewing is crazy. And people be bringing in snacks, of course, you know. But they like so disrespectful with it. Like, I forgot, it was like three people that came in one time, right? It was like two older people and then that younger dude.
Oh my god, bro.
First of all, we were so happy to see that movie. And then for them to like, they ruined majority of the movie for me. Like, I get irritated really fast. Like,
they kept talking. Like, she had a whole bag of chips. Like,
whole bag of chips, popping the chips.
OMG, like, look. Somebody is sitting.
Oh my god. That's where you be sitting.
Why they couldn't sit right there?
Look, it's our seat.
But why they couldn't sit right there?
That's what I'm saying.
We right here. Why they couldn't sit right there?
We were where?
Right here.
Exactly.
Why they couldn't sit right here?
Why would you want them to sit next to me?
No, these are our seats right here.
Exactly. What the heck? Why are you acting slow? One person can sit on each side of us. And they're sitting on the inside where you usually sit. What the heck? Yo, bro, she's losing her mind, bro.
I'm thinking we got those two. Why I said they could have sat right there. You want to see what
I'm saying? Oh, I get it now. Now we got that. We always get that one edge seat. That's
Wait,
why.
Are you sure?
Yeah. She is. Okay. Bro, she had me like, what are you talking about, bro? We just was talking about it. But,
Oh, we could move over if anything.
That's why we do it. That's what I'm trying to tell you, bro.
I'm not saying nothing.
That's why I'm trying to tell you we good. We're gonna move down. Hopefully somebody don't buy it. But that whole row, like you see everybody on the edge. Nobody sitting on the edge. You gotta be a complete weirdo. Like that's how I feel. I'm not even being funny. Like I genuinely feel like you're a complete weirdo if you pick the seat. Cause I look at the pull up the list again. I guarantee there's like one seat like in the middle or something that you could find that no one is sitting at. I just can't stand when people do that.
No.
I don't say you're a weirdo if you go to a movie by yourself. If me and you were like, well, if you were a movie savvy and I couldn't find nobody else to go to the movies with, I'll go to the movies by myself. Movie savvy, what you mean?
Movie savvy, I don't
remember. Yeah, if you didn't like going to movies like that, I definitely would go by myself. Yeah, that's what we're doing. We got a whole bunch of things planned for tomorrow, and then we're gonna try to stay without the phones for as long as possible. I know it's gonna be hard for her.
Right,
you see what I'm saying? There's a middle seat right there.
But yeah. I don't know if they was with somebody.
Yeah, no, I know that. I'm just saying, if there was one person and they was to sit and they was trying to look for seats, don't sit next to the freaking. I mean, I understand why they do it because it's the top row. Everybody wants to be on the top row when they go to the movies. But don't freaking sit next to us, bro. Like, go somewhere else. That shit really pisses me off. One time, one person sat. What? The heck did you just ask me?
One time, one person what?
One person sat next to us, but he wasn't bad, though. You remember that dude? Okay. It's like a white dude. And he was like more to his, like, yeah, he was like more on his side. He wasn't really bothering us for real. Dang, did I take her where she was trying to go? Oh, I think she was trying to go here. Damn, she was. Her tank is on that side. She was trying to pull up and go here. Am I an asshole? I don't know.
It didn't really look like it.
She was. Am I an asshole? Oh.
If she look at you, do
you know? Yeah. You took her shit. Yeah, I took her shit. I'm an asshole. She's pissed. She is pissed. I don't know.
That's a big ass
shot. What's so funny? Guys, right, so I'm about to put you on to game. So if the gas pump got one of these where you tap it, it don't take the money out until like 3 days. you just, they just ask you for your information. And then, hold up. And then you just fill up. Fill up and you straight. I definitely think we took her spot.
I don't think so. How she was going was like weird.
She was trying to
maybe
back up.
Maybe she was too big to, cause that truck is big and it was a truck right next to us.
Maybe.
So I don't think she could have fit.
I don't know.
Unless she was gonna, get it from right there.
No, she was gonna, damn, what the hell? It's from a freaking gas pump.
Stop rubbing it in.
It's coming off. What you mean? Gotta rub out as much as possible. That's how I stain, bruh. If you let it sit there. Come on now, shorty. But yeah, basically the gas trick is if you got a tap, if it has tap at the gas station. I don't know about any gas station, but here at Sunoco, if you got the tap, you put the tap in and ask for your information. And then you fill up. And it don't take the money until like 3 days later. It's a good tactic. I suggest doing it when you know you're about to get paid. Alright, what the heck is wrong with this lady? What the hell's going on? Bro, she's...
Her gas tank is open.
I think she's moving again. Bro, I don't know what the hell's going on with her. But yeah, I suggest you do it when you know you're about to get paid. So that, like, the day you get paid or whatever, it take out the money. So it's like you ain't...
You think so?
Oh, she's taking. I always feel like if you don't press that, then they take the money. But this is how much it took. I was almost on empty. It took me $45. And it's $3.79 for a debit or credit card. Gas is expensive. So the gas trick worked, y'all. And y'all seen that. But the thing about the gas trick is they take out $1. So that's how you know it worked or not. I know they got it out. Go.
No.
Go ahead. Go ahead. You welcome. What the heck? He said it wasn't gonna let me. Nigga, what the fuck do you mean? Fucking, yo, people are crazy, yo. Crazy as hell. But yeah, the gas trick. Oh my
you.
God. I can't.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you. Right back around. But yeah, take that $1 and that's it. But we getting Popeyes and we get these coupon codes so you can get the joint cheaper. Because Popeyes is expensive, bruh. That ain't like $10 for a 3-piece tender. And I don't even think that's including the combo. So we going back around because she about to use her coupon now to get the same thing I got.
People make me so happy. Can I get the 3-piece tender combo?
Side order.
Fries.
3-piece tender with fries and which drink?
Fruit punch. I have a coupon code.
What's the code?
2673.
Alright, and what's the sauce?
Mardi Gras mustard.
Would that be all?
Yes.
Purse.
Nah, you did that on purpose. You're doing too much. That's right on top of me. Freaking weirdo. Alright, y'all. So we got our food. Stop, bruh. We got our food. We finessed them. Because they always be like, you can't use a coupon twice in one drive-thru. So we finessed them. And we got
it. One in the same transaction.
Yeah. So we did it. Like that. And now you about to eat our food. But then after we're gonna write on a piece of paper the GPS coordinates. Write on a piece of paper the GPS coordinates for tomorrow. And then we gotta go get that box too. Today. You understand what I'm saying first?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Alright y'all, so you about to go prepare for this video for tomorrow. Did I tell them that we was going to get the box? Well, yeah, basically we gotta get a box to put the phones in. Cause this is real deal shit. Like, we're really gonna be without the phones for the video. Like, I know people be capping a lot of shit. Like, I've capped shit in my life too. But this is like real deal, like.
You capped shit in your life?
Yeah, I definitely capped a lot of shit for YouTube in my life. Like, you know, pranks and shit like that. I'm so happy that I can like say shit like that now, cause I don't do them shits no more. Like, I'm in a whole different,
what? You prank people? I thought it was all real.
Shut up, yo. Yeah, I'm on a whole different lane on YouTube.
And
we're
gonna
now
throw the key in the ocean.
Alright, we ain't doing all that now. But yeah, I'm in a whole different lane now. So now, like, my videos aren't like pranks. But if I do prank videos, now I can actually do real prank videos. You can't. Listen, y'all. I'm gonna tell y'all something, alright? Because this shit, I feel like a lot of people don't understand this shit. And it goes over people's head. You cannot prank somebody every fucking day. Like, genuinely, you can't prank somebody every day. So a lot of things are scripted and they're staged, and it's just for entertainment purposes. It doesn't mean that the videos aren't good. I've done a lot of prank videos that were great videos that came out so good, because it takes a lot of good acting, a lot of good, you know, conversation to make the video seem believable. But me personally, I've always hated doing those videos. I didn't like doing them shits. It was like almost forced out of me going to her house at night and having to prank some.
Don't blame some none on videos. Me. Don't blame.
And then
me.
Having to get her to do it. Just
he was pranking before me.
Yeah, I was. But
you was. But
I'm talking about recently.
We haven't did a prank video in like 2 years.
Yo, you are so capped.
When did last time
we just did a prank video, bro?
What video?
Think of the last video I posted on YouTube before I started doing this shit. Was prank videos and
it was
shit.
A video.
The title didn't say prank, but just
what
because
like, what was that?
Me asking
that
you
was
to
like a year ago.
Me
too.
No, it was not. Yo, bro, she be. Oh my god. Anyways, y'all, we about to go get the stuff prepared for this video, and also we gotta write down GPS coordinates. All right.
Coordinates.
So we on the way to Rite Aid to get the box. We tried to get this cage. I wanted to get this phone cage because I really want to like invest my money into what I'm doing, but I couldn't get it done. It wouldn't have been here in time. I can't risk it saying it's gonna come. When it said it was gonna come on Wednesday? Mm-hmm. And then you sometimes will say it come Wednesday, and then Wednesday comes, it's just like, oh, it's gonna come tomorrow, then tomorrow comes, and it's like I just ordered a phone cage for no fucking reason. Why are you doing that? She's like Spider-Man crawling on my fingers. Like, what is going on here? What is wrong with you?
Spider-Man crawling?
Yes, Spider-Man crawling on my fingers.
How, what is that?
This is what she was doing. This is what she was doing to me.
I was not.
What you was doing there? Show me.
I was like this.
You was, yo, she be lying, yo.
Prince, I was not
you
like
was
this.
Wiping,
I was not like that.
You was wiping my hand.
What?
You was wiping my hand like that.
Like what? I was like this.
Yo, all right. We going to,
Chipotle.
Get this done. I just heard talking. Where did I hear talking from? Oh, right there. She too much, bro. This is what I deal with on a daily basis for her.
I literally did not do anything.
Shit is ridiculous. We never, did we ever come to this Rite Aid before? We never come to this area. I don't think I've ever been here like a day in my life.
Donuts over here?
For real?
It's a little bit funny. You see it?
What? I don't see it.
I applied for
I know it was a Subway.
Is
yeah, that's what I'm saying. This is called the Greenway, y'all. This is some Stratford shit. That's the car we had in Florida. What? That's a sign you want to move to Texas. If you want to move to Texas, just tell me that. It is cold. We was going to go to the other Rite Aid, y'all, but uh-uh. That shit was the ghetto. I'm a little bougie now. We couldn't go to that other Rite Aid because even back in Stratford make you want to be around civil people. Now that, I ain't even being funny. That one was like, People, too many people was coming in and out. Somebody was like literally stationed in front of it. Like, nah, I don't got time for that. Would it be back here? I'm here to get a medical lockbox for the video tomorrow. I like how they got the band-aids now with the color. The world is improving day by day. Shake it, bounce.
Shake it, bounce.
Yeah, cause it definitely ain't down here.
It would say an owl on it. It gotta be over here. If they probably don't got it, cause look, they got the first aid kit things and stuff like that.
That's not really a medical. That's more like a.
I got $5 million in one thing to do.
It would have to be over here in this area.
You're going Home Goods? Buy me something.
Eating pies down there. All that. I don't know.
Oh, my stuff's over here.
Maybe over here.
I'm okay. You got everything you need?
Over here? For your home? I didn't see it over here either. I don't know, bro. I knew this was gonna be the hard part. It's trying to find something. In such a short amount of time. Maybe back here. This is diapers and stuff. We need a worker. No, we need a worker. I think it was, oh, it's right there. Dang, is that gonna fit our phone?
Right here.
Right here. It should fit our phones. What the heck? How the heck you open it? It should fit our phones though, but we gotta make sure.
You can't do it.
Let me see. It might be just enough, right?
Gotta take the case off. But it's gonna be like this.
Oh yeah, we could put them up too. All right. Wow, that's an interesting spot to have it right there. Right there, and it's literally only two left.
I was like, it's not even like the other ones.
This is an interesting spot to have it compared to over there with all the medical stuff right there. Have it right here is an interesting spot. But thank the Lord we got it. Did it say the passcode on it already?
I think once you take this off.
Yeah, so you can twist it. Hopefully it fits, y'all. But we need that for the video tomorrow. The video gonna be out already by the time you see this, so if you're watching this, make sure you go over and watch main channel video. Link is gonna be in the description. Let me see. Gotta record me. It just fit. It literally just fits.
All right, can you get it out?
Well, how you getting anxious?
Yeah, like it's gonna get stuck.
No, it's not.
I'm taking my case off when I do it though.
You just had to slide it this way. He was sliding it this way. He was locking it more. There we go. Record me the whole time. That should be.
You know what we might try, gotta get?
You ain't even recording me, right?
What? A nail shit came.
Your nail shit came?
Yes. like the rest of it.
Oh, it's all delivered already?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I gotta go. I just looked in there. They probably don't got it.
What?
The brush.
I don't know what you talk about. Let me put this in the car first. You could go in and I'll go put this in the car. But, yeah, so we need this for the video for tomorrow. We're gonna put our phones in this and then. Yeah, no phones for 24 hours. But I'm gonna return this for sure. Cause I have no value for this at all. Like literally none. What am I gonna do with a lockbox? I don't keep cash. There's nothing I would keep in this thing at all. Like nothing. So that's why I kept that receipt. Because after we do this, guess what? It's coming back. You feel me? You feel me? So. Yes, indeed. We put this in a safe spot in mother freaking car. Put this in my glove box. There we go. We gonna keep this for this later on. We ain't even gonna take it out the take the what you call it out of it either. Take the sticker off it. Just leave the sticker on there. No cap. Them mother going back for sure. Call me what you want, but don't call me on your sidekick, shawty. Because I never answer when it's private, shawty. I want a bigger car, bro. I just been so into bigger vehicles. Motherfucker Tahoe pulled up. I've been into bigger vehicles. What the heck? What happened? They didn't have it? See, that's why I told you. That's why I wanted you to go. Cause you view me. You view me. I said, well, I'm returning that thing. When we done, that thing going back. No cap. No cap. That's cheap of me to return it. Is it?
Cheap, my nigga!
What the heck? What was you looking for? A brush?
Not a brush. I'm about to start doing it tonight.
We gotta do the GPS thing.
Can I see if they have my Walmart?
Yeah. You gonna take your nails off?
No, babe.
So what are you talking about? How you gonna do it tonight? Are you painting and stuff before you put it on? I'm about to say, you just got them nails done, you nuts. I know you excited, but damn. Yeah, well, we'll hit y'all once she finish finding what she can find. I'll be telling her to throw her cup out, bruh, because she'll leave her cup and her junk just sitting in my car, bruh. She think my car her room and shit. Just cause you leave your room junky, don't be trying to leave no junk in my shit. The fuck? We at Walmart to get what she need. We been taking sacrifices, ain't that right? Buying stuff that you need for your business, ain't that right? Ain't that right?
Don't play with it.
All right.
It's cold. I should put the jacket on.
Yesterday it was 80. Now it's what? Like 40 degrees out here.
40-0.
Shit crazy. How you go from 80 to this in one day? Like, how's that even possible? Damn. Bro, they going extremely fast. Anytime somebody drive by now and I got this, they just be staring at me.
Don't you think it's a gun?
No, not anymore. I think when I had the black on black, yeah, but now, because it's got the red in it and stuff. I don't think so no more. I don't know. It is big though. I'm looking at it in the mirror. This shit is huge. What I was just telling her was why she ain't see if they had it at Target, because I hate Walmart.
Target.
This is both Trumbull, but I don't know if they consider it Stratford or not on the thing.
Yeah,
I think they consider it Trumbull.
They do, but it's Tiger.
But yeah, I was telling her I don't like Walmart no more.
I just feel mad weird in here. They need to upgrade. They did upgrade because they added like the groceries logos and shit up there, but they still need to upgrade. They need to do better. They don't got it.
No, they do, but I don't
want to. You want to see the address? Oh, it is Hollyland. They do got it. Are you sure it's the right one? It's stay in stock? You know how you be. Pick up. Okay. We going all the way to Target just because I hate Walmart. Ain't that something? Give us a reason to go to my favorite place.
Yeah, okay, had to cut her off, that bitch was acting up. If that hoe a 10, I take my chances, might not wrap it up. Life is just a race and I've been running, y'all not catching up. I just heard your new shit that you dropping, now start cracking up. Ha ha.